Yes! Welcome to the Now, I'm Ashley.
And I'm Adam.
Everyone loves playing Skyrim, right? I mean, you know, we've been got it on like every platform ever now. It's second only to Minecraft. It's got vast open spaces and castles and dragons and arrows and knees, lots of knees. It's a huge world to explore. And what would be more fun than playing Skyrim besides playing it with all the mods that make it prettier? Other players, right? That could be cool. That could be a lot of fun.
Well, that was the dream of a free mod called Skyrim Together, which wants to let gamers play together online. But Bethesda dumped a bit of cold water on that dream recently when it decreed that it wouldn't allow the mod to be released on Steam. The mod's developers say they're still going to put it out, but it's going to take a lot more work and the release date will now inevitably be pushed back.
So it's kind of weird, but it's a story that highlights the kind of occasionally uneasy relationships developers have with modders. Sometimes they make really awesome programs that extend the playability and the lifetime of a game, make it look better, add all kinds of new stuff, even new landmasses to the game. But all the while, they technically do exist at the whim of the studios, who can make life a lot more difficult if they want to, in which case, they seem to want to do.
Let's give you some more background on this story first. The Skyrim Together co-op mod has been in development for years, and it's promised what lots of people have been clamoring for, multiplayer in Skyrim.
And that sounds great. Initially, the mod's developers said they plan to release the first stable version of the mod before the end of this year. After the release, the mod team says they also plan on creating an API that will allow players to implement and then craft their own mods within Skyrim Together.
There's been a lot of interest in the mod too, which isn't surprising given the popularity of Skyrim and the potential of getting to play it with friends. A subreddit devoted to the mod has nearly 10,000 subscribers. The team even set up a Patreon to pay for dedicated game servers that's currently earning more than $2,000 a month from more than 300 backers.
A few days ago, however, fans got a little bit of bad news. Bethesda is saying no to the mod, on Steam at least.
The bad news was shared on various subreddits, with one of the mod team writing, "Some news, guys. We have been in discussions with Bethesda, and while they are fine with us releasing the mod, they weren't with us publishing the mod on Steam. And we relied heavily on the Steam's API for party and lobby systems."
Now, one of the developers of the mod elaborated in the Skyrim Together subreddit, saying, "We contacted Bethesda regarding releasing the mod via the Steam store as a mod for Skyrim. We aren't allowed to release the mod as a game, obviously, so we had to seek permission from Bethesda to do this."
And Bethesda said no, without giving a reason. So obviously that's bad news for fans of the mod, but on the bright side, the mod's developers told gamers that it will still be released and they're not stopping development, which is good.
It's just gonna be harder.
Yeah, but it's going to take a bit longer considering, like they said, that the mod utilized Steam APIs to make it work, so now they're going to have to develop an alternative system.
Well, it's also probably gonna make it harder for people to use as well, because if it was via Steam and it was already using the Steam APIs, then you would just be able to play with other Steam users, presumably. This means that everyone may have to find workarounds for it somehow in order to play together. The mod makers in their announcement said that Bethesda's decision will push back the dev a bit while we figure out a way to make our own party and lobby systems. It might sound like a trivial task, but we expect thousands of concurrent players, meaning we need something that scales well, and that's a complicated story.
Actually, that doesn't sound like a trivial task at all.
I mean, look, there are, like, if there's one thing that everyone understands, it's how easy it is for netcode to suck.
Right. It sounds like a shit ton of work. Of course, we've seen multiplayer mods pop up with varying degrees of success.
That's, back in 2012, a group released a multiplayer mod for Just Cause 2. That one was awesome. They got the blessing and support of the game's developer, Avalanche Studios, and everything. That mod is still being supported with updates as of this year, and it was ridiculous.
And last year, a multiplayer mod for Just Cause 3 was canceled after its lead developer was hired by Avalanche to work on the game itself.
I mean, like, if you're gonna stop working on a mod for any reason, working on the game is a pretty good reason.
It's a great reason. But another multiplayer mod created by a different team continued to develop, and the mod was released in January. Oh, and it's available on Steam. So this has happened successfully before.
It can, but it's also not just the Just Cause games, although the multiplayer mods for those have been great. There have been mods for Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, Torchlight 2, everyone's favorite Euro Truck Simulator 2. Even another Bethesda game, Fallout 3, got a multiplayer mod successfully.
So why did Bethesda block Skyrim Together on Steam?
Because they hate us!
We don't know exactly, but the announcement led to some speculation that maybe Bethesda wants to release its own multiplayer mod for Skyrim via its dreaded Creation Club.
Oh no!
That was certainly a popular theory online, and with some people preemptively accusing Bethesda of being greedy.
Well, others have noted that the decision does seem to be a little bit odd considering Bethesda's embraced the modding community in the past, even allowed the modding tool Skyrim Script Extender to be available on Steam. So why would they not want Skyrim together and have people playing and then playing the game together if that's going to retain the player base and keep people involved with Skyrim, right? It seems like everyone wins.
As one Redditor said, all they're going to do is try to make a bullshit creation crap version for like $30 that would probably only work about 10% as well as Skyrim Together would. I miss when Bethesda encouraged modding. Others wondered, why didn't Bethesda just hire the Skyrim Together team to make it an official version?
Now look, again, we don't know if it's Bethesda not wanting to allow a possible competing product. That does happen sometimes. In fact, we've seen it happen with other games in the past before where something gets shut down. They don't explain why, and then it's because an official version comes out and suddenly it all makes sense. Or maybe they're, I don't know, maybe they are just being dicks this time. There's gotta be a reason that they don't want it. Still though, good sign that the Skyrim Together team isn't letting the setback kill the project, even though it means they've now got a lot more work ahead of them.
What do you guys think of the Skyrim Together mod being delayed? Is Bethesda being jerks about
this? Are they keeping us down?
Let us know in the comments.
And for all your Skyrim and modding news, hey, it's just about to hit VR and it's hitting the Switch, so that'll be interesting to see. Make sure you like this video. If you're new around here, subscribe to the channel.
But it's going to take a lot more work and the release date will be inevitably. Blah, 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 blah. The Skyrim Together co-op mod has been in development for years and it's promised what lots of people have been wanting. Fuck. And it's... But on the bright side, the mod still...
Should be the mod's developer.
Sorry, got it.